Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the A-Side. I am your host, Riley, and I got a new laptop. What do you know? So now, that means album reactions are back because my computer is not bricked. That being said, I had to, reconfigure all my settings. So let me know how the audio mixing sounds, if I'm too loud or if the music is too quiet or vice versa. Let me know if it needs any tampering because I had it set for quite a while to where it was good. Now, I don't know. Anyway, today we're going to be reacting to the brand new album by punk band PUP entitled The Unraveling of PUP, the Band. Now, I believe some of you in my comment sections have mentioned the band PUP before, although I am familiar with them. 2019's Morbid Stuff was one of my favorite records of that year. Their style of super nihilistic but very blunt lyricism really stuck with me. I mean, some of these verses just really hit, like on the first verse of Kids. Just like the kids, I've been navigating my way through the mind-numbing reality of a godless existence, which at this point in my hollow and vapid life has erased what little ambition I've got left, and I've embraced the calamity with attachment and a passive disinterest, living out the back of my 97 Camry, wondering how the hell I got myself into this. So yeah, their lyrics tend to resonate with me. I love how passionate and emotive the vocalist of the band is. He's not really, I mean, he's singing, but kind of scream singing in a way, pouring all his energy and emotion into it. So I'm really excited to hear this new record. I'm going to be doing the first half just as a test run for this new laptop. It seems to be running like a dream. And I thought, hey, let's listen to a record I want to hear and just listen to some good songs together, man. So let's just dive into track one, Four Chords. So I don't know if any of you know who the YouTuber Yuri of Wind is, but I think the lead singer of this band sounds a lot like Yuri of Wind, and I think it's funny. Turn this up a little bit. Show me four chords. It should be enough. New music. Opening on a piano ball is interesting. It all makes them sick to their stomach. Four chords, okay. I never liked them. I'm assuming it's based off the four chords of pop music. Oh, the distortion on that guitar sounds so cool. How fuzzy that is. Only the best. This band's very good. Oh, this guitar solo has me ascending. Oh, I love the fuzziness of it too. It just scratches a certain part of my brain. Yeah! And the feedback reminded me a lot of Weezer. You know, I love me some Weezer. Except the new EP was bullshit. Oh! And it bleeds right into second track, totally fine. I'm gonna give Four Chords the green just for being a little intro. It really just itched a good part of my brain with that fuzziness to it. Loved it. Excited now to hear the rest of this record for sure. Anyway, yeah, I really enjoyed that. But before we continue, I forgot to say this. If you're new around here, go ahead and subscribe. It's free, and you can always unsubscribe if you want. Yeah. Just get into it, totally fine. Track two. Very distorted. This record sounds just really distorted. I like that though, how fuzzy and crunchy it all sounds. That's a really good riff too, like really jammy. Almost sounds a little garagey. The kind of more strip, like lo-fi, fuzzy production sounds very garagey, reminding me of like White Stripes. I really like it, though. I think it's cool. I love the group song vocals. Wow, he's pouring his whole heart into these vocals. Lately, I've started to feel like I'm slowly dying. That hurts, man. There's that nihilism of just hopelessness in lyrics. A lot more experimental in a sense than Morbid Stuff was. It feels like they're just pushing their music to like a limit and like past those limits, you know, like how fuzzy and distorted they can make it. Lately, I'm starting to feel like I'm slowly dying, and if I'm going to be real, I don't even mind. That just hits me. I love how blunt the lyricism is, too. I'm not sitting here trying to dissect the shit. Like, it's just boom, and then you feel it, you know? It doesn't always need to be this wild poetry. Just sometimes just stating how you feel in the most blunt and obvious way possible can just be a slap across the face. I love this. Interesting. That was a banger, man. I love the lyricism on that. Like I said, just so dark yet blunt. It's just an emotional slap on the face. And I loved the riffage on it and the fuzziness. It almost sounded like a White Stripes song in places, that kind of garagey, fuzzy vibe. Totally fine. Definitely gets the green. The next song here is called Robot Writes a Love Song. And I find that quite interesting. I like that title a lot. And I'm wondering if it will be, like, a song on Morbid Stuff, Bloody Mary, Kate, and Ashley, where it's about, like, summoning a demon and, like, falling in love with it. I wonder if this will be kind of, like, tongue-in-cheeky and funny like that. It's one of my favorite songs from Morbid Stuff. So I'm just interested. Robot Writes a Love Song. Almost sounds like a Weezer song. And like the messy kind of dissonant chords and the fuzziness. You were dead. Saw your corpse rolling out the door. Wow, what an opening lyric. Oh my god. You were dead, I saw your corpse roll out the door. That is like the hardest bar ever. No rapper could match that. Oh, that's the drum machine. It's an interesting touch. Along with, like, the beachy, like, organs in the background. Really interesting touch to their music. Ooh, I like that guitar line a lot. This This is so unlike Pup. It's like weirdly new wave. Because it's Robot writes a love song, so it's gonna have like synths and drum machines. That's a really cool touch. Is there any room in your aorta? And it's gonna be like weirdly like scientific and literal in places, like a robot were to write a love song. This is brilliant. Oh my god. Love the messy guitar. Reminds me so much of Weezer. That was Robot Writes a Love Song. I have to say, that song was absolutely brilliant. I loved it. The fact that they took that concept of, oh, robot writes a love song, and then, like, ran with it, so then they, like, kind of mechanized the music to make it sound like a robot really wrote a love song with drum machines and synths. That's just a really cool touch. I also love the lyricism on it, how it's, like, weirdly, like, literal and scientific, like a robot would like is trying to write like love poetry. The wearing my cargo shorts down in Florida, can I live in your aorta? You know, that's what I get from that, and I think that's a really brilliant move. And it shows that this band is just on another level. The fact that I can just shitpost a song and still have it be amazing like that, and parts of it, like the really messy guitar, reminded me of like a Weezer song in a way, just like a lot fuzzier and more distorted. That was brilliant. My favorite song so far, Robot Writes a Love Song, gets a green. Next track, track 4, Matilda. They're really just hammering their guitars, aren't they? Just some great, kind of danceable punk. And no, I don't think they're a pop punk band. I've seen some people label pop as pop punk. I love pop punk, but I think they definitely lean more toward punk. Ooh. It's just like really clean, beautiful singing, really great melodies, and then the pretty guitars in the background. That's really good. Here's this really pretty part again. I love the guitar here. That's like indie, almost, like an indie guitar line with some really beautiful melodies from the vocals. I'm a sucker for a really pretty melody line. That's part of the reason why I love churches so much, just because Lauren Medbury always had the best vocal melodies. That sounds just, it's sweet. I like the, how sweet it sounds. Thank you. I like that song a lot too, especially on the chorus, how sweet the chorus was, with the really kind of pretty guitars, almost indie-esque guitars, remind me of like early Killers, just a little bit, maybe a little bit of like Neon Trees, I don't know. There's a certain vibe I'm getting from that. And then the really sweet, kind of beautiful melodies. I love a good melody line. Gets the green, man. Matilda was great. Relentless. This is going to be probably a really... Watch, it's going to be, like, called Relentless, and it's going to be, like, the slowest, like, prettiest song on the album. No Maidens? I like the guitar noodling here. It is probably like the slowest on the record so far. Oh, never mind. I just love how loud and overbearing the guitars are. It's just so buzzy. It's like a wall of static has taken over the entire mix, but in a good way, you know? It's endless. Ow. Talk about lyrics that are just daggers through the heart. Fuck all the dread. It's relentless. You can't kill it like you want to. I don't get into my personal life often, but wow. That speaks volumes to what's been going on lately. The instrumentation here is gorgeous, too. I just love the guitar tone on this album so much. I don't know, but it's just scratching a part of my brain. So beautiful, oh my god. I don't know if beautiful is the right word, but this guitar tone is just so good. The fuzzy static of it, that's just kind of like slowly drowning out his vocals. So good. And a little slow down at the end, just to kind of get the guitar here. A little less distorted. Sounds beautiful. Wow, lyrically, that song hit me so hard. Fuck all the dread. It's endless. You can't kill it the way you want to. It's relentless. Wow. And then the instrumentation there, when it just kind of took over in about the middle of the song and just swept me away to another place, man. It gets the green. I'm only doing the first half in this video, just so I can kind of get it out. It's been a while since I've done any album reactions, so I want to get this out to the world. So let's end with a 27-second song, Four Chords Part 2. Eh?
The board of directors.
And it's a continuation of the first song.
The budget is shrinking, and we can't agree. So we vote on the issues. Like, are we tuning the vocals? I say no, and I vote to end democracy in this fucking band.
Nice. Hey, that's it. That's Pup. We've done it. That's the first half of the unraveling of the band Pup. My first album reaction, and I don't know how long. it's been a minute. Lots going on in my life, but the main thing was my old computer. It's bricked. It couldn't handle it anymore. But now this new laptop is really good. Actually, I spent quite a chunk of change on it. Actually, I think the last album reaction I did was and it's from up here. It's been a while. So yeah, if you watched and enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe. I'll be back for part two, don't you worry. I won't fuck it up this time and end up like part two of Black Country New Road. It'll actually come out. If this album continues the way it does, it might end up being my album of the year. So far. It's really good. I'm really liking it. I know how to close the video out. So, thank you for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. Thank you for sticking around. Support's been insane. Yeah. Thank you for watching. I'll see you all next time.